One person is dead and two are wounded after shots are fired in an Ocoee home. Good afternoon. I'm Jim Payne.
I'm Martha Sagowski. Now police are trying to figure out who pulled the trigger. It happened at a home on the 500 block of Bernardino Drive just before 6 this morning. West 2's Michelle Meredith is there live right now. And Michelle, what are police saying about this deadly home invasion?
Well, they're telling us that the victims that survived, the brother and sister, are still in stable condition, and police are very anxious to hear their story. Crime scene tape, crime scene trucks, crime scene techs. Police say it's not what you usually see in this quiet Ocoee neighborhood called Harbor Highlands. But then again, police say unusual things keep happening at 503 Bernardino Drive.
We're waiting for the victims to stabilize, and we're going to hope to talk to them and do some notifications.
Police say around 5 this morning, the house was the scene of a violent home invasion. 3 people were shot. Police say the victims are a brother, sister, and a third man. 2 survived, but a young man in his late teens or early 20s died on the scene.
To see something like this happen in your own backyard is like dramatic.
Police say the same house was the target of a home invasion in May, and although no shots were fired, according to the police report, guns were pointed at the victims' faces and heads. The suspects demanded the address of a man named Dallas, then took one victim's cell phone, which was used to track the suspects.
The fact that this home has been the subject of a previous home invasion, what does that tell you?
It's pretty scary. We want to know what's going on, definitely. Last time, I know they inquired about narcotics in the house, and that's something we're going to look at again this time.
Is that a possibility?
Oh, yes, very much so.
Police are anxious to interview the victim so they can learn more about what happened. The neighbors just want it all to stop.
Every news truck is here, and the police are here, and the crime units are here, and it is unnerving.
Back live now, police have just taken down some of the crime scene tape. At this point, police have not released the names of the victims. Live in Orange County, Michelle Meredith, West 2 News.